Hello everyone, it's Old Guardian here. The Hearthstone balance patch seems to be running a little late. It doesn't look like we're getting a patch this week after all. So, because the meta is still evolving, it's a good time to take a look at what decks are the best decks to climb with. If you still want to climb with before the patch comes, maybe next week? And we also have a new meta Tyrant this week, so let's take a deeper look at the best decks. Coming in at number 8 is Beastroid. Beastroid looked a little bit more promising last week, but it was a newcomer, okay, people are now used to playing against it, and it's on its downward slope at the moment. The best performing Beastroid deck according to statistics is still the original list, with all those 4 legendary cards, which when you look at the statistics of the deck, are by far the weakest performing cards in the list. Speaker Kidra, Kasagus, Wildheart, Gough, Ivus the Forest Lord, I don't think they belong in this list. And I have been experimenting with alternative takes of the archetype, and in particular Mark of the Spike Shell has really inspired me. So while I don't have a statistically significant sample size of Beastroid yet, if you don't happen to have the 4 legendary cards that you need for Beastroid, you can also try out a cheaper version of Beastroid that replaces those 4 legendary cards because they don't seem to be doing a whole lot in that deck, and try something cheaper and possibly even more effective. Coming in at number 7 is Aggro Druid. Aggro Druid is returning to the best decks list and it's surpassing Beastroid again. These two have been going neck and neck, but what makes Aggro Druid good right now is that it is one of the few decks that has a good matchup against Poison Rogue. Poison Rogue is now very, very strong and Aggro Druid is able to fight against that, so Aggro Druid. Even though many of its other matchups are not that great, but having that great matchup against Poison Rogue and having great matchup against Facehunter too makes Aggro Druid a potent deck to climb the ladder with. If you're Alliance, I just hope that you have reached Grand Marshal already because I disenchanted my Drek'tar, and I'm still 1 week away from reaching Grand Marshal before I get the Golden Drek'tar to replace it. Yeah. Or maybe you picked Horde, in which case, Aggro Druid. And this week's number 6 is Quest Hand Warlock. It's the same list as ever, why would you change any cards? The list is perfect. The only thing that changes is the meta around the deck, because Quest Hand Warlock, one of its key tickets to fame is that it has a fabulous matchup against Thief Rogue. It also happens to have a great matchup against Beastroid, and there was a bit of a Beastroid craze a little while ago, so yeah, Quest Hand Warlock was like, yeah, this is cool. But now, Poison Rogue, being the new meta tyrant, that's bad news for Quest Hand Warlock, because Quest Hand Warlock is not good against Poison Rogue. And the number 5 deck at the moment, still undervalued, still great deck, Quest Shaman. Also suffers a little bit because it also has a weak matchup against Poison Rogue, and Poison Rogue is so hard on the rise. But Quest Shaman has a bunch of other good matchups to compensate, such as a great matchup against Liberum Paladin and against Aggro Druid. Aggro Druid being one of Poison Rogue counters, then yeah, you can kind of like help Poison Rogue players by playing Quest Shaman. Well, maybe I should have ditched this deck from the list, but yeah, you can do that. And the 4th best deck to climb the ladder with is Facehunter. Facehunter, no cards have been changed recently, Facehunter is just facehunting as usual. And Facehunter is happy to see more Poison Rogues around because Facehunter is one of the best counters to that deck. But it also has weaknesses against some of the other popular decks like Rimmer Paladins and Thief Rogues, so everything is not great for Facehunter, but still solidly moving on. Last week, my number one recommendation to climb the ladder with was Liberum Paladin. And Liberum Paladin is still a strong deck. And one of the great things about Liberum Paladin is that it has great matchup against Thief Rogue. But the rise of Poison Rogue has been less kind to Liberum Paladin. It's not a terrible matchup, the matchup is close to 50-50. But obviously it hurts when you were used to, hey, I'm meeting a rogue, awesome, I'm going to crush them. And then instead facing Poison Rogues and then facing a 50-50 matchup, not as much fun. Liberum Paladin, still a great deck, but a little bit weaker than it was just a week ago before the rise of Poison Rogue. The ladder currently really is a 1-2 punch of rogue decks, because the second best deck on the ladder right now is Thief Rogue. Because Thief Rogue has good matchups against Facehunter, and against Aggro Druid, and against Quest Warrior. So Thief Rogue is good against everything, pretty much, that Poison Rogue is bad against. And then Poison Rogue is good against everything that Thief Rogue is bad against. Yeah, it's really hard. The matchups just flip around depending on what kind of rogue you're going to be facing. And of the two rogue decks, Poison Rogue has become the stronger one, and Thief Rogue is now playing the second violin. And the biggest meta change that has happened in the past week is the rise of Poison Rogue, and specifically this hybrid Poison Rogue list, which takes the good cards from Tifrog, which is Master of the Masquerade and two White Bog Gnolls. You don't have to take any other cards from Tifrog. The other stuff, not that impressive anyway. Just having some gnolls come out real quick after they have been discounted because you have been disguised by Maestra, and then using three card slots for the gnolls and for Maestra means that your ability to finish games with spells is diminished. There's no Sinister Strikes in this list. So it's more difficult to pull off OTKs. You don't have any spare tools if you want to OTK people. You have to be very careful about your damage spell use. But in the current meta, that is more than compensated by the early tempo that the gnolls give you. The deck is not without counters. Face Hunters and Aggro Druids can be very challenging for Poison Rogue, and even Quest Warrior is a little bit unfavored matchup. But the early tempo from gnolls gives the deck more potential to just steamroll matchups that it has even been unfavored in before. The meta keeps evolving as ever, and now we have reached a point where Rogue has really established its dominance. We'll see if we get a balance patch next week and whether that's going to hit the Rogue decks, maybe. That's what everyone's expecting anyway. But until then, Poison Rogue, this hybrid list with Wild Bog Gnolls, best deck in the game. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and check out my Twitch channel.